Good evening. Today is the 15th day of March 2017, and we welcome you to our continuing series, Sri Aurobindo Ashram, the Early Years. And today it is a great honor to be with Jayanti here. And we welcome you. Namaste.
Thank you so much. Namaste to all of you.
Jayanti, when did you first come to the ashram?
I first came to the ashram at the age of 6 with my parents. And at that time, ashram atmosphere was completely different from what it is now. Maybe because Aurobindo was in his body. At that age also, I was very sensitive and I felt as if some sun's rays were pouring into the ashram courtyard. And
when you were only 6 years old, you felt
this? Yeah, 6 years. And I knew at that time, but I couldn't explain, that it was not the sun's rays, but it was some radiance I felt. But I could not explain at that age. But later on, I came to know that it was the radiance of the Aurobindo and the mother along with that was pouring in the ashram courtyard. At that age, I did not realize, but later on, I realized. And then we had more contact with the mother at that time because she used to meet us whenever we came with my parents. And she blessed us. As children, we ran to her. At that, we didn't realize that we were meeting a great avatar. And when we said goodbye, my parents took us up the meditation staircase and up to the last 5-6 steps. Mother, with her hair let down and in a gown, she used to come early morning. When we said goodbye, she came and blessed us at that time, all the children. And we went back. Like this, several times we came and went back with my father, who was working as an engineer in Kadalur.
And you were staying for only a short time?
Short time. Two days or maybe like that. But every time, whenever mother came out, we used to go and see her in the courtyard when she came back after the meditation, the playground, wherever she was. We were very free to go to her.
When did you finally come?
I came finally in 1972, May. Actually, I came only for 15 days and then stayed on here permanently. Because the turning point in my life came when I had a serious accident, car accident, which turned my life completely. Because that time when I was going to my postgraduate exams, I had that car accident and mother's blessings, which was sent by Vasanti, did not reach me. And mother was informed about it. And she said there is an adverse force at work. So she took a locket in her hand and concentrated on it and gave back to Vasanti for me to wear always. So then I put it on a chain and I'm still wearing it. And then after a few months, I got a serious attack of jaundice. And I was almost gone 9 days, I was semi-conscious. And Vasanti went on informing mother. That time she personally met her and told everything to her. And then that time also she said some bad forces working against her. And after that, when I recovered, I was very ill and a lot of pain surfaced. That accident pain surfaced with the weakness of jaundice. And doctor said she is having ankylosing spondylitis, which is incurable because the vertebra between the two spinal were getting deteriorated. And gradually she will be bedridden. or a wheelchair case.
Oh.
And I got such a shock, and I said, no, mother, when you are all there, I will not be bedridden, I will not do, not have it. And it so happened, but all doors seemed to close on me, because I was going to be a lecturer in my college, because I was a first class student, and I had a very brilliant career in my college, and also my singing career. Everything was gone, because I could not sing without severe pain, and I could not do anything at all. And lying down I had pain. And that time, this Jipmer hospital had newly come, so Vasanti said, there are very good experts, we'll show you. But when I went there, they were surprised to see me because I was looking very healthy. I said, why have you come? You don't look a patient. Then when they saw my x-rays and examined me, they said, she should not even sit for half an hour. Her condition is so bad. And they prescribed some injections, everything, treatment was going on. But lying down, my pain was not much less. And I rested, and then I stayed on. My mother said, you go on staying on. And mother had allotted two rooms next to Vasanti's, to me and my mother. Though at that time we were not ashramites, we used to come very regularly here. So she allotted those two rooms to us, which was for which we are very grateful. And I went on staying there, and with Vasanti's support, no doubt. And then one day, when I was lying down with pain, Vasanti used to go out, because morning and afternoon they were busy in their ashram work. And almost tears were coming to my eyes. And then I felt two hands cool on both sides of my head. And after a short time, I fell asleep. And when I got up on the pillow, I saw two small pieces of peacock feather. You know, two strands of peacock feather. I said, what is it? Then had Krishna come, it looked like Aurobindo. I felt, what is this? And immediately took them and put them in my Ramayana book to show to Vasanti when she came back. Then she told me, I'll inform Madhavji, he goes to mother, we will show those to her. But next morning, when we saw them, they were not to be seen, disappeared from the book. So I didn't know what to do. So I said, okay. And then same time, Vasanti had put a harmonium for me because I was in pain. Evening I used to sing bhajans. And when I sang Krishna bhajans, some of my friends came there. And when I sang them, in the other corner of the room, in a bluish aura, I saw faintly the figure of Sri Krishna with his flute. I was very surprised because I felt I was not such a great devotee. But this has happened. And I remembered all this. And every day, evening, I used to sing. And especially when I sang Meera bhajans from the film Bhakt Meera, which Subbalakshmi has sang. When I sang them, I felt too much devotion coming into my heart. And I saw this bluish residence.
Let's go back a ways, because I heard that at the age of 11, you saw Sri Aurobindo.
Yeah.
Could you tell us about
just that? When I was 11, that was on April 24th, 1946. And that was the most memorable and unforgettable experience of my life. Because even now, it is etched in my memory. That was when my father went to take permission for my parents and elders in the family. I went with him to Nolinida's room. And I said, I have to have his darshan. Everybody is talking so much about Sri Aurobindo's darshan. I should also have it. But my father said, no, you can't have it. You are only 11. you are underage and mother will not give permission to you, because children and women who go to him who are little weak, they can't bear his force. The force is so great, and I don't want you to make a fool of yourself there falling down or anything. I don't want to take you. But I said, no, Nolendra, I have to go. Then Nolendra said, the child is saying so much, I will ask mother. And he asked mother, and mother said, yes. And I went there with my parents. I even remember the dress I was wearing. I was wearing a supramental color blouse and a skirt, which my mother had made, with my two plaques. And in one hand, envelope for offering, in another hand, flowers. And I was the only little girl in front of my father and mother. So when we reached the room, I felt I should have a look at him before I go further, because there were 7-8 people in front of me. I just peeped from behind my father, and oh God, that was such a terrible experience for me. I saw Aurobindo as Himalayas, so big. Maybe I saw his Vishwarup. That was maybe Vishwarup Darshan. So big and vast like Himalayas. And two points of light immediately came from his eyes, bright, and entered into my eyes and went through my body. And I shook like a tree struck with lightning. That is my experience. And immediately I took my eyes away, and because I was shaking, I was afraid that I may fall down. And I remembered my father's words that you may fall down or do anything, don't make a scene there. Then I immediately tried to steady myself with both my hands, clenched fists, I stood, and tears were rolling down my cheeks. It was such an experience. And then I just clenched my fist and steadied myself. And then when everyone passed by, I came near Aurobindo, but I wanted to see him, but afraid to look at him. And then I just put the offering and looked at mother. Mother was in half-closed eyes in meditation. But then I passed by, and by coming down also, I felt I should see him. But I was afraid, you know, at that time, that I may fall down or anything, again something may happen. And I came down. But much later I learned that that is an initiation from the eyes by the Guru. And it has been written by Sri Kapali Shastra in one of the verses. That it is initiation from the eyes. That was the most unforgettable experience of my life. It was once a lifetime, because afterwards I couldn't come here. My father was transferred from here. So then Aurobindo passed away in 1950, December. And I cried so much that time, because I couldn't go again. Yes. Because my father had told me, I'll take you again. But that again never happened. But he has appeared to me once or twice later. Some years later, when I was here, I was walking from my rooms to the ashram. And when I was entering the ashram, I saw Aurobindo when he was very thin with a black beard and very thin with black hair, standing at the entrance of the gate on the right side. And people were passing by talking like anything, not looking at him at all. They didn't know he was there. I said, what is this? People are passing, not doing pranam to Aurobindo, who is standing there. And I rushed at him, fell on my knees and clasped his knees. And I said, beloved Lord. And I felt thrilled that I was the one who recognized him. And when next day mother was informed, mother said, yes, this is a very good dream and experience. All her past karmas will fall off now. This dream will be very good for her future.
I understand you are very close to Nalini.
Yeah, Nalini da also. Always we used to run to his room And whenever we came and went, we met him. He was very fond of me also. And because he gave me the first darshan, no?
Yes.
And when Nolinida took samadhi, samadhi means when people like him pass away, we say they take samadhi. So when he took samadhi, his body was laid down in the meditation hall where mother's photo is there. And at that time I was suffering from trigeminal neuralgia, 24 days on one side, 24 days on the other side. And there was needle pricking pain, and every now and then I had to be given painkillers. And 103, 104 temperature. And the day Nolinida took samadhi, that was going to end, my trigeminal neuralgia was going to end. I didn't know. I had 103 temperature, and my mother and Vasanti were going to pay their last respects to him. I said, I must go. And then I put on a sari and went, and I took one rose in my hand. When I saw him, I saw fully a golden aura, supramental color aura around his body. And Vasanti saw there were specks of gold all over his body. And then we just went round, and I placed the rose in the tray which was beside his body. And I just said, Nolinida, many, many grateful thanks to you and my grateful pranams for giving me that one unforgettable experience of having darshan of Sri Aurobindo. Immediately, rays of gold came from his body and struck me. And when I went back home, all my fever was gone. And from that day on, that pain didn't come at all. Gradually, I recovered. And one doctor from UK who had come, our friend, he told me, there is no medicine for this, and there is a medicine which has got more after effects than the pain. So you better not take it. And this cured me. So spiritual power, how much it has got curable effects on people, you can see from my experience.
You made some notes.
Yeah.
Can you share some experiences and remembrances from your notes?
I remember the darshan, balcony darshan of the mother on 24th April 1956. I came here after my matriculation. And we had gone to the balcony darshan. When we stood there, I suddenly felt heavy on my head, and I saw bars of gold coming through from above and through my body, and they went into the earth. And I saw bars of gold, lines of gold I can see, coming through my head and going through my body, entering the earth. And I felt so heavy, I just stood quietly. That time tears used to come readily to my eyes, and tears rolled down my eyes with this experience. And then when the balcony darshan was over, Vasanti felt something happened to her. So let us sit. She took me and made me sit on the pavement below the balcony. And then she asked me. Then I told her what happened. And she reported it to Madhavji. And Madhavji told mother same morning. Then mother said, yes, today there was a horizontal supramental descent. I wanted to know who all had felt it. And then myself and Panditji's sister, who was standing nearby, she also felt it, her elder sister, Sundari Akka. Both of us felt it, and mother felt very happy that we felt it. That was another experience. And then last year's experience was a great one, which I would like to tell you.
Please.
In about September, October 2016, I was feeling very much depressed. Mostly I don't get depressed or anything. Always I'm bouncing with joy. But all kinds of problems I felt I had to face here. And also I felt down in my health. And I thought, what is this, Mother and Sri Aurobindo? Why I am like this? I'm never like this. And every day I repeat the Mahamrityunjay mantra. Maybe you know that.
You can say it, please.
Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukameva Bandhanat Mrityor Mukshiyam Amrata. This mantra I always repeat.
Every day?
Yes. Every day, 108 times. It takes me 25 minutes to complete it. And it has to be done with great concentration and when you are alone. So, after all my duties, at about 2:30 in the afternoon, I used to go to rest. And when I did that first time, I saw Sri Aurobindo and Shiva between my eyebrows.
The first time
you did it? The first time. Because somebody who gave me, told me, you remember Sri Aurobindo because he is your guru, and remember Shiva because he is also Shiva, then it will be very successful. So, as soon as I repeated, without any effort, I saw Sri Aurobindo and then Shiva on my, between the eyebrows. And then, when I repeated first time, two chrysanthemums from my heart, yellow, went and fell at his feet. And then I didn't know what it was. When I asked Madhavji, he said, it is chrysanthemums are a symbol of life energy.
Yes.
I think because of good, for good health, I was repeating it. I've been repeating for years. But this experience of 2016 came to me when I lay down here. And when I started repeating it, suddenly my subtle physical went to Sri Aurobindo's room. Outside Sri Aurobindo's room, there is a meditation room. My subtle physical went there automatically. And I saw I had a plate of chrysanthemums. And Sri Aurobindo was sitting on that armchair. And the sunlight was falling on him. And he was having his a shawl around the left shoulder, mm-hmm. and he was, I found him quite alive, with kind eyes smiling at me, and with a sweet smile. I just bent down and went on repeating and placing the flowers. Whenever I repeated once, I put them. And when I put them at his feet, he slightly bowed down to bless me. And like that, it went on and on for 25 minutes until I finished it. And when I finished it, I just came back here, onto my bed. And I was wide awake on my bed. But how this happened, I don't know. But this happened. And then I felt so much joy and bliss having been with him. And all my depression, everything went off, and I became my old jolly good self. This is the one which happened recently.
Have you seen Mother often?
Yeah, Mother I've seen very often. And I told you she gave me this locket.
Since 1973.
I must tell you, the day she took Samadhi, I saw her. I saw her also in a big form. What happened in 1972 for my birthday when I came here, Madhavji told me he will request Mother to put her, pass her hands on my spinal cord because I was having pain. So I said okay. But Mother withdrew. 72 I went to her. But 73 birthday, he said he will ask Mother to put her hand on my back. But she never saw anyone. So that year I couldn't go to her. And 73 November she took Samadhi. And Madhavji came early morning at 4 and knocked on our door to tell us about mother's taking Samadhi. But somehow the previous night I was feeling such gurgling in my stomach and I felt so ill. I told Vasanti, is anything happening to our mother who was in Chennai? I didn't think of this mother, but I thought of my mother in Chennai. But she said, I don't know why you are feeling like that. I felt as if someone dear to me was going to part from me. And then early morning when Madhavji knocked on our outer door to take us to the mother's couch, immediately I felt it must be mother. And I started feeling such palpitations in my heart. And when we went there, both of us went with Madhavji and saw her lay down on the couch. And I could not control my tears. But Vasanti told me, pray to her now. She is sitting on a throne. And also she is sitting, I find she is sitting on the lion also. Please pray to her, whatever you want to. And then I told her, mother, you went away without passing your hand on my back. Now what am I to do? And I felt so bad. But then I came back home and Madhavji and Vasanti left me there and went away somewhere. And I lay down on my bed because it was only 4:30, 4:45. So I lay down. Then I could not control my tears again. I was feeling so unhappy that mother left her body without passing her hands on my back. I saw her coming through the garden door to my bedroom in a huge form. She was wearing that kind of maroon coat like that gown she is wearing. In one of the photos she is there with that. She came inside and I felt she was saying, why are you crying? I am here, I am here. I felt in my heart. And she came and passed her hand on my back. And immediately all the pain went away. 1 month I had no pain. And Vasanti came back, she saw my face very bright. Then I told her this experience. And after that gradually I recovered. So this is a miracle, I should say.
Yes.
Because doctors had told me in 1972 itself, that either you will be a wheelchair case or will be bedridden. And I didn't want to be like that. So I told mother, no, this can't be. Because I was a very active person. So this is what happened to me.
I'm glad you are so honest about your experience when mother took Samadhi, because it was the same for me.
For that?
Yeah, same for me.
Mm.
Yeah. I couldn't control my tears.
Yeah.
And I wish I could, but I couldn't. Yeah.
But after this experience, I felt she was there, so I didn't cry anymore. She was with me.
Same. Yes. Yes.
Another experience of mine where I saw my Ishtadev's avatar Sri Rama and mother were the same. Because from childhood I used to worship Sri Rama, the divine incarnation of Vishnu.
Yes.
You must be knowing.
Yes.
And I was so impressed by two films on Sri Rama, and in which Sri Ram gave two of his sandals to Bharata when he went to rule in Ayodhya. So I got two beautiful silver sandals made for me. And since then I used to put flowers. Then I was only 8 years old. From then on I was worshipping Sri Rama and reading Ramayana every day. And I used to repeat one of the mantras in which it is called Ram Raksha Stotra, in which every part of your body is protected by Sri Rama. There is a special stotra for that. That also I learnt by heart And every day after bath, I used to repeat it. Once when I came here, in about 1968 or 66, I don't remember, I started repeating it in the evening, and I could not continue halfway through. I was so surprised, because since childhood I have been repeating by heart. I didn't need a book at all. How did this happen? But then I felt, maybe I should not say this here in the ashram. Maybe I should not repeat this stotra or whatever it is. Same day, after a while, I saw in a circle in my heart, Sri Rama with his bow. And after a while, he disappeared and mother came in that place. Then mother disappeared, Sri Rama. Like that, it happened several times. Then I knew that there was nothing wrong, that both are the same. She gave me that. Because I felt, no,
yes,
that maybe I should not do it here. So this is another of my experience. And on 8-8-1988, which was a special date of the mother, when I went to mother's room, I told her, frankly, within 1 minute, mother, I don't know, I am devoted to you, doing service to you, but somehow I feel there is some kind of a curtain between me and you. I am not fully yours. What it is, I don't know. You have to cure me of that, because I don't know what it is. And then I came down. Within 15 days, I met my husband, from whom I was parted for more than 25 years. And I was surprised, because I never even asked that he should give me. But I thought maybe this is an indication. And when before I met him, I had gone to Madhavji, and Madhavji had given me 2 blessing packets. I told him, only one you should give, there are 2. He said, there must be some meaning, you keep both of them. Then the other one I gave to my husband, whom I came to know that he was very devoted to mother. And he told me of one of his experiences, that when he first saw mother, after separation from me, once he came to the mother, and then he didn't see the mother as we saw her. He saw her as a goddess sitting on a lotus. And his mind started whirling round and round, and he sat at the mother's chair. Then mother patted on his head, then he looked up and saw this mother. So from then on, he had so many experiences which did not tell me, but clearly. One experience I can tell you about him, when he was bedridden with osteoporosis severely in 2003, I was sleeping beside him. Then I prayed to mother, we are turned to you, and we had already done 2 CDs on the mother and Aurobindo in 2002. And he only did all the recording, bought the equipment, everything at home, because I couldn't go to a studio. And on mother's 125th birth anniversary, mother's was released and Aurobindo's also was released shortly. So, 2 CDs I have done as adoration to them. And then I told mother, what is this, why he is bedridden like this? Because doctors say he will not be able to get up, serious osteoporosis, that he won't be able to walk, he won't be able to sit like that. And then, and I went off to sleep. At night, mother parted the curtain of our room, and she stood beside his bed and looked at him for 15 minutes, not saying a word, but just went on looking at him. And I didn't know. He rubbed his eyes and thought, maybe I'm having some hallucination. No, mother was standing there. Every 5 minutes he saw, he was there. After 15 minutes, she vanished. And then next day, when a friend came, he could not even turn on his side, he could sit. And after some months, with good physiotherapy, I was going on praying to Mother. He walked out to this room and he could watch TV. I feel this is really a miracle the Mother has done, because doctors never thought he could even sit up. So this is another one. And then I'm so grateful to Mother and Sri Aurobindo that they have given me, poured on me and showered on me all their love and grace, blessings and protection. Because in my old age they have given me all comforts, whatever I need, and only to do service to them. And when I was very ill in 74-75, I asked Madhavji for some work, because I could not work in any department with this kind of a disability. Though my pains were much relieved and all that. And I was walking about because of Mother's grace. And then he gave me this correspondence work of sending blessings, receiving offerings, giving to the ashram, receiving the receipts, sending them, blessings for all the devotees. So at that time I told Mother, I am doing very little service to you because I am not too well. And I could not even write an address for quite some time very clearly. That was my condition, back condition. And then I told her, like the squirrel which carried a small pebble for Sri Rama's bridge which was being built, like that I am doing for you. And then now it grew, it has grown into a tree, I should say, because I am writing all over the world to so many people, and so many devotees get benefit of Mother's grace and Sri Aurobindo's grace. I get the feedback that immediately when they phone to me or send an SMS or write to me, they are getting relief from their problems, whatever they are. So this is another thing I have to say.
Let's take a break for a few minutes.